cry on me. We see that all they adore me. Women, I love the normal. Now they like aren't you adorable? I know the question rhetorical. I try to tell play from Oracle. Mama never used to cook much. Used to Chef KD. Now me and Chef KD. They don't stop at 20 G's. I brought the gang to his knees.
It was fun, man. It was a fun ride. You know, it's kind of a little depressed now that it's over. It was so much fun. And to be a champion and to win the way we did. The selflessness we showed as a group, that's what basketball is all about. So it feels great to be a part of something special like that.
All right, you just said it's kind of sad that it's over. So I know you've been celebrating, lots of smiles. Did you play 3-on-3 ball growing up?
Yeah, we had a tournament called Hoop It Up in my neighborhood. It would be this high. And this many courts, well, not this many courts, but it would be a lot of basketball out there. So that's why I learned really how to just, you know, the competitive nature of just playing outdoors and playing in the heat. It's another level of focus you have to have. So I definitely commend you guys for playing
on the streets. What type of, like, toughness does street basketball bring to you that you kind of, you know, you apply to your game now in the NBA?
Well, I grew up playing street basketball. That's how I honed my skills. And, you know, getting knocked down and scraped up and bumps and bruises. That's just a part of everyday life playing on the streets. But for the most part, man, you just want that respect. And I think when you go out there and get that respect from your neighborhood, you can take that anywhere. So just taking you across the country here to school game right now, watch you guys, and we started to play street ball.
Yep.
All right, you're known as Mr. Versatility. You guys see the banners, a lot of the messaging.
always, always. Right? So what, tell me a little bit about the message and how that, how your game has kind of brought that to life.
Like somebody just hit a big shot over there.
Yeah.
So, but just always, you know, trying to go out there and get buckets any way I can, you know, yeah. Just from shooting threes to posting up to playing pick and roll, whatever. I just try to get buckets as many different ways as I can, try to be unpredictable out there. And the other way is just me being me, always sticking to what I've been doing, just adapting to the league, and no matter what goes on around me, just, you know, staying true to those, you know, values and that, you know, that I learned as a kid as a basketball player.
Now, along with that, you released some pretty sweet shoes, right? The KB10s, they were released here first at Hoop Fest. We're always really lucky to have a great partnership there. You are literally on top of the world right now. And you chose, he chose to come here to Spokane, Washington.
I mean, without the game, then I don't know who would be here. So it's always about the game. Everything else, we all gonna come and go, but the game is always forever. So you gotta give back to the game.
A big, big thank you from Spokane Hoop Fest, from the city of Spokane, to all of you for coming out. I think you made it.
Steps back on the black, please. Everybody take a step back. Back up. Everybody need to back up.
Dominate going in, yep. Is the biggest part for me, and he did.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So cheers to that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Way to dominate that.
Had to.
Hell of a championship.
Thank you, sir.
Hell of a championship.